I tell guys to shoot for between like 10 and 15 phone numbers a night out, okay? Now, say you just set like four of those for dates and you close two or three out of those four, now you already have more closes overall. What's up, guys? John Anthony here from John Anthony Lifestyle. Today, I want to talk about the importance of mass setting dates. Okay, dates are the key to results, the key to getting lots of girls, the key to building a good size rotation, the key to getting a full package girlfriend. The path to all of those is to set a bunch of dates. And I'll go through how to set a bunch of dates and why it's so important to getting a lot of results in this game. But before we continue, if you are new to the channel, this channel is full of efficient, effective, optimized strategies for knowing the most probabilistic moves of what to do across the entire seduction and pickup game. I come from a background of poker and chess and computer science and engineering. I used to work on ballistic missiles for the US government, and I'm just very good at optimizing systems. Okay, so please subscribe below if you have not already. Jump on a free 30-minute call with me as well, with a link in the description if you want to learn how to get very good at this. And press the notification bell after you subscribe to be alerted of those new videos every single day. So, a lot of people in the seduction and dating community, they say that you need to get very good at being able to take a girl home from a bar or club or take a girl home from the street, okay? Now, while that is important, and I'm extremely good at it, and I teach guys how to do it very, very systematically and with very high chances, it's far better to get lots of phone numbers and set up lots of dates, okay? And the reason for that is on a date, you have perfect logistics, okay? When you run a date, like say you meet a girl for coffee or drinks, you can set it right near your house, so now you're 5 or 10 minutes from your house, okay, or less. You are one-on-one, so there's no friends to cockblock you. You have time to sit and actually connect, and presumably she doesn't have anything to do afterwards, okay? And there's no distractions. There's no fucking DJ and music and alcohol and their friends taking them away and them needing to go to the bathroom and blah, 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 okay? So for all these reasons, you don't have to like extract her from a bar or club or anything like that, right? For all these reasons, when you get good at running a date, it's pretty much gonna be a game over, okay? You know, I get most of my clients up to a level where they're closing 80 to 90% of their dates. So if you get a girl out on a date, there's a good chance you'll be able to close her. Take that by contrast to when you're in a nightclub, okay? If you try to take a girl home from a nightclub, you have to convince her to leave all her friends. You have to convince her to go off with a stranger. Maybe you don't even live that close by. You have to battle against what's gonna be happening after, which is lots of times she needs to sleep. Maybe she has work in the morning, etc. Maybe she already has plans for afterwards, right? You're dealing with other guys possibly coming in to talk to her. You're dealing with alcohol. You're dealing, you know, which you don't know, you know, what state of mind she's in, etc. There's music and distractions, and it's just like a totally different ball game. Okay, and it's gonna be much harder to navigate that situation successfully all the way to closing her. And you can only do that once. Okay, there's been plenty of times that I've brought a girl home from a club, banged her, gone back out, brought another girl home. But usually you can only do it once, okay? And most people won't even do it once in a night. So what that means is I tell guys to shoot for between like 10 and 15 phone numbers a night out, okay? Now say you just set like four of those for dates and you close two or three out of those four, now you already have more closes overall, okay? So the key to closing a lot of girls is going on dates. And I tell my guys all the time in the mastermind that you need to be just mass setting dates. The name of the game is acquire a steady lead flow at the top. You have your online game, your night game, and your daytime game. The online game is Tinder, Bumble, Hinge, and you know, some other apps. The nighttime game is bars and clubs. The daytime game is streets, malls, grocery stores, etc. And those are all gonna lead to phone numbers. Then your text game, okay, what you send to get them out on dates is gonna be extremely critical. And I have a whole product devoted towards that called the Leads Machine. I'll put the link in the description for that, sexleadmachine.com. And that's gonna tell you how to optimally take a phone number to setting up a date with it, okay? And then for the dates, you need to be able to run them systematically, etc. But the whole key to closing and getting lots of results is just to keep setting a lot of dates. So the name of the game is to move a phone number down to a date setup. Okay, so you're constantly pushing logistics, proposing that the two of you meet in person. You're gonna get objections when you suggest to meet, lots of the time. You're gonna get logistics objections, safety objections, hookup objections, comfort objections, okay, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And I tell you what to do in all those cases in the Leads Machine product. I also explain it fully in my 8-week mentorship program and that content. And you can jump on a free 30-minute call with me if you're interested in that, okay, to learn that whole system. So basically my point is you wanna just keep getting those leads, the phone numbers you have, keep getting them set for dates. And when you do that, it's going to generate a lot of opportunities for closing. And when you're good at closing, when you can do that 80-90% rate, it's just going to be a matter of acquiring the leads, setting them for dates, and knocking them down. And that's going to bring in regular closes. If you do one close a week consistently, which isn't that hard once you're doing all this stuff properly, that comes out to 52 new girls a year. If you do two new girls a week consistently, that comes out to 104 girls a year. So just doing some simple math, if you're acquiring 16 leads a week, 16 phone numbers from a combination of online, night, and daytime game, and then you set four of them, 25% for dates, okay, and then you only close half, 50%, then you are going to end up with two closes for that week. If you do that all year, you know, you've slept with over 100 girls in a year. And yes, it's not all about racking up quantity, and a lot of people don't want to bang 100 girls a year, and they think that's gross, et cetera, et cetera. However, it's going to still get you to your goals as fast as possible. If you want that dream girlfriend, surprise, surprise, you're going to need to level up your confidence and charisma by going on a bunch of dates and working your way up in your average quality. Okay, nobody just jumps from dating average girls or below average girls to a full package 9, 5, or 10. Okay, it just does not work that way, as much as we'd all like it to. You're not ready for that yet. You haven't gone through to develop your calibration for how you're interacting in social settings. You don't have the skills down to never run out of things to say. You don't have the skills down to sexualize things properly and deal with anything she throws at you and you know, have the willingness to walk away and everything, because you don't have access to girls like that. And et cetera, et cetera. There's a whole big explanation there. But being able to go on lots of dates and getting a bunch of closes is going to fast track you to your dream girlfriend, your dream rotation, or just acquiring a lot more closes, okay? So the last thing I'll say about this is, even if you don't have much free time for dates, or let's say that you work 9 to 5 and you do other shit, maybe you only have one date slot per night that's open, right, or two. It doesn't matter, you should still mass stack them, mass set them. So you should be, the name of the game is just to keep setting them for dates. A lead is stronger once she's already agreed to go on a date with you, even if you have to cancel or reschedule later, because now you're no longer just some dude she's texting with in limbo, but it's some dude that she has the intent to meet up with. So given that, you should just be aggressively setting dates as much as possible without any regard for if you even have time in that slot. So let's say you have just like 7 p.m. open on let's say tonight I only have 7 p.m. open. I'm still gonna try to put like 2, 3, maybe even 4 girls at 7 p.m. And what's gonna happen? Some girls are gonna say, well, I'm not free tonight at 7 p.m. Oh, okay, well, when are you free? I could do tomorrow. Okay, now, boom, now you just got a date out of it by trying to set a date in the first place. Now you have a date for a different time, so that schedule conflict didn't even matter. Maybe you get 3 girls out of the leads you're working, maybe you get 3 girls to agree. As it gets closer to 7 p.m., maybe one girl has to cancel or one girl has to reschedule, okay? Or maybe one of them just flakes completely. Now you're down to 2. Then out of those 2, maybe one is down to come straight to the house. Maybe they're about equal attractiveness. One is down to come straight to the house. The other one wants to meet in public. So you tell the one that wants to meet in public, hey, actually something came up. I have to do something else. Or I have something for work that came up. Can we meet another day? Is that cool? Yeah, sure, no problem. Okay, boom, now you have another date set up. But if you had not mass stacked, or let's say 2 out of those 3 flaked, now you still have a date. So it's flake insurance. Okay, because things do come up in people's lives no matter how good your game is. There's coaches on YouTube that say if your game gets good enough, you'll completely eliminate flakes. That's full bullshit, and it's not realistic whatsoever. You know, of course, things come up in girls' lives that are out of their control. Things come up in your life that are out of your control, too. And not every flake is like a shot at you or disrespect. Okay, and I see a lot of guys, my mentorship, especially early on, they're trying to like punish the girl. She's like, hey, I actually am gonna have family in town this weekend, so I can't meet you. And the guy's like, hey, that's not cool. You disrespected me. And the girl's like, what are you talking about? And he's like, you should meet me anyway. You know, like, if the girl has a real reason she can't meet, you don't need to punish her or push or whatever, okay? So, point being, hit that lead target each week, that 10 to 15 or 15 to 20 leads per week from a variety of all sources, online, night, and day. Text them properly, and that's a huge fucking system, and it's extremely difficult for the average man to do it properly, and near impossible. So, you know, to a high degree of competence, you know, I should say. And that's fully explained in my leads machine product, sexleadmachine.com, link in the description for that, or explained in the mentorship with the free 30-minute call link in the description. But then you have all your dates set. Don't worry if you already have a date set for that time slot, or if you don't have the time, just set them anyways. It'll make the lead stronger. And then you just get good at running your dates and closing them out, okay? And then you just get good at the retention game, and now you have a full system. If you want to get that full system in full detail, and be fully trained up and advanced and have a permanent solution so you never need boot camps or training or products again. Jump on a free 30-minute call with me. I'll go over the entire program, how I can help you from a custom level based on your current situation that you're currently at, where your, what your goals are, what your weaknesses are, etc. And we will see if it's the right fit. If it is, I'll go over how you can get started. If it's not, that's fine too. Okay, thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe if you have not already. Notification bell for those new videos every single day. And I will see you on the next video. Take care. Some do it for the income, but we do it for the outcome. Some of us are active while others just let their mouth run. No doubt, son, this is not just about fun. We will not be outdone by these cowards who shout scum.